Welcome back, Observer. Vassia is under siege. Within the shadows, madness begins to take hold of our party as they struggle to survive and cope with the dangers that await. There are things uncovered in the shadows that should remain hidden. Remnants of the past that are not what they seem. Come, Observer, as we follow another unfortunate soul whose tale in the shadows has yet to be written. As we journey forth, may laughter be your companion and kindness your guide. Now, Observer, let's see where the dice take us tonight.
You've heard rumors as of late that there's been interesting happenings within the city of Durval. And knowing that the occult things out there are a bane on society, you have decided to take it upon yourself to make your way there and set things right. You quickly come across something of interest. As you see a tall, very thin man leaving the area, you follow it. Clearly, this is wrong. It shouldn't be here. You spend the afternoon stalking them, and at some point, shortly after sunset, he rushes out of his home. And you give chase as much as you can from within the shadows. You follow him to a location where a building is seemingly missing as one of the meteorites is headed towards you. You are in a somewhat hidden position, but you watch as the meteorite strikes into the man that you've been following, the man that smells of death. You shield your eyes for a moment, and when the bright flash of light ends, you turn, and the man has been what you can only assume to be vaporized, as he is no longer there. No. Do you run towards what is happening, away from what is happening, or do you try to hide in place?
You said that was me.
Yeah.
So you named yourself No.
Yeah.
I'm gonna be out. Sorry, my bad. Like, stay in place and observe what's going on.
You see things begin to come out of the storm. A series of additional airships come out, although they're covered in some type of fleshy substance as you watch, and they engage the airships that were parked over the city. Do a perception check for me.
Here's your first roll.
Oh, shoot.
There it goes.
All right. You feel the presence of something behind you.
Can I whip out my bow and jump back? 10 feet. Sure. All like turning towards it.
Sure. As you turn to look at it, you see a strange portal open, and through the portal you can spy what appears to be some kind of just a starry landscape and a strange alien world. And through the portal walks a massive four-legged creature. It has a kind of grayish flesh. Its legs are probably each 6 feet off the ground. Its body thin yet appropriately large for the height that it is off the ground. And then you look upon its face, and it is, it has greasy black hair, and where you would expect its face to be, there is nothing but a void, a hole, and inside of it is a pile of eyeballs.
Stop moving any closer. Take one more step and I'll put an arrow through your eye.
The creature cares not and continues to approach.
I'll take a shot.
All right. Roll away.
Oof.
You take a shot and it hits the creature's hide and it does nothing.
I'll turn and run.
Okay. All right. As you turn to run, you leave whatever hiding hole you were in, the alley, and you make a break down the roadway. You can still see the meteors coming flying in left and right, smashing in front of you. And as you make a break for it towards the sea, running down, you can see the sea, and out of the sea you see numerous monsters, creatures of all kinds, coming out of the ocean onto the shore. And as you witness that moment, a meteor, one of these meteors, comes flying and hits you just as it did the man that smelled of death, and you fall unconscious.
After closing the door, Greer walks back to the room and just leans in to go, guys, it's raining spores out there.
V is going to pop his head out of the tent very groggily and look. So, what do you mean spores? What's going on?
I mean spores, like mushrooms, fungus, I don't know. We could use harrow.
Do you think it's harrow?
No, I don't think it's harrow. I've never seen her make this.
Maybe she sneezed really hard.
And Esger looks at you, you just get the thought of, he's lucky, he's cute.
V, you hear that. Gaaraa, you also hear that.
And I'm sort of just rubbing like the eye boogers from my eyes from sleeping, and I hear that in my head and I'm like, who said that? Did you guys hear that?
I didn't say that out loud.
Huh? What do you mean you didn't say that out loud?
I have no idea what you're talking about.
Oh, no, that was weird. Gaaraa, you okay? I had the weirdest dream in the world.
So Gaaraa is just kind of rocking back and forth in his corner, and you could hear him thinking, or he's thinking, stupid Gaaraa. They're not gonna let you join the Aces High if you keep fucking this up.
V is just very confused as he's hearing these voices. Am I hearing it in their voices, or am I just getting...
You're hearing it in their voices.
In their voices.
As if they were speaking, yes.
Gaaraa, I can't really see you. What do you mean fucking things up?
I didn't say anything.
And as you guys look at V, you hear in his head, what the fuck is going on?
I don't know. Well, and Gaaraa is saying this out loud because he thinks you said it. So he's just responding to you.
Why am I all bruised up?
Mister woke up in the middle of the night with no memories and proceeded to try and leave and get yourself killed and also call me a crazy bitch. At least several times. Thank you for that.
You know what? That was in my dream. And it was very, it felt very real. It felt like me, but it wasn't me. It was weird. Your face was twitching.
Yeah, that happened.
Is that a normal thing? I don't think I've ever seen your face twitch.
No. We all, except for Siren, for some unknown reason, we all had weird shit happen last night. You couldn't remember who you were. Gaaraa was basically himself, except he thought something was out to kill him. I don't know.
I just remember you and I wrestling. Not sure how to take that. And
you tried to leave.
Okay, yes, I remember that much. And I remember you guys wrestling with his undead friend. And then his undead friend just getting up for no reason and letting you guys go.
We got tackled by the zombie because you convinced Gaaraa to make a break for it. Siren managed to get Gaaraa and then managed to talk you down.
So wait, you're telling me this actually happened and it wasn't just a dream?
Exactly. Hence why I got no sleep last night.
I don't know. This place is already getting to me. I don't know what's real and what's not. I feel like I'm going crazy already. Wait, so we can hear each other's thoughts?
It might, I mean, yes. Like I said, it's raining spores out there, and I don't know if that has something to do with it or not. I don't understand this world. But if which case, if we can read each other's thoughts, well, fuck.
Well, fuck indeed.
All right, so on our way to scout the power source, look for food.
Yes. Do we want to go out into those spores? I don't know if I want to breathe that in. I have really bad asthma.
Since when do you have asthma? You dance constantly.
Since I got here.
In Greer's head, you just hear, do not punch his pretty face. Do not punch the pretty face.
Okay, well, I heard that.
No, you didn't.
And you could hear Gaaraa thinking, be in your best behavior. Do the best you can, and you can still be a part of the team. Let's go.
You know, I admire that you talk yourself up before taking action. That's a mark of a true hero.
In his head, you can hear.
Okay, he laughs like that in his head, too.
Let's say. That's
weird.
Physical mouth breathing and mental mouth breathing now.
I didn't know that was possible.
Me neither.
I guess I'll summon Benedict to follow my lead.
Hello there, morning. Both of you hear that voice in addition to his moans.
Ooh.
Gaaraa, you just hear the normal him.
V is looking around, wondering where that sound came from. Well, Benedict, it's good to finally hear you. Do you remember anything from before you were this?
No, mate. I don't remember much outside of hanging out with Ga.
Oh, you guys have nicknames. Okay.
But as you're taking note of what is around you, you hear the creak of a door come from across the street, and you note a series of individuals walk out. No, you do note that the man that smelled of death and the robed companion that was following him is there. You do immediately see that the man that was in the robes is in fact undead.
I have my bow aimed at Gaaraa.
I see the bow, and I just raise my hands up, hands trembling.
And seeing this, since Greer's in the lead, she steps between the line of fire and holds up her own bracer, ready to fire at him.
I promise you this arrow will leave the string before you have a moment to react. Who the hell are you?
I think you're outnumbered. And you should tell us who the hell you are.
Numbers mean nothing as long as I get the first shot.
Greer releases a dagger from her bracer, and DM, if you'll allow it, just want it to thud into the wood next to his head.
Okay. Do a... still do an attack roll.
Gotcha.
As this is happening, you hear the door behind us creak. V has run back inside.
Okay. No, you watch as a dagger goes whizzing by your head. It appears to originally be coming for your head, but you do note fairly readily that it's not actually going to hit you.
That was a warning. Care to try again?
You think these fear tactics work? Twitch even a little bit one more time. I promise I will release this arrow.
I whisper to Benedict. Benedict, just like we practiced, and I command him to charge at this mysterious figure from a different
angle. I'll whip my bow towards Benedict and fire.
As Benedict goes to turn, because I guess Gaaraa said that out loud, and you just see him, he turns to you and he begins to walk forward and you fire, but as you're firing, he's just going, "Hey, mate, it ain't a big deal." And you shoot him, and he takes the damage.
I just, in my head, "Oh, Benedict, be careful. You're gonna get hurt."
And then you say, "Hey, mate, why are you doing that? Why is people shooting?"
And Noh can hear this?
Yes, Noh can hear it. But you also hear the, like it's happening both at the same time.
Why the hell am I hearing that voice in my head?
Welcome to the club, so are we. We woke up with it this morning. Now who the fuck are you?
Can I tell it all that she's also a Bloodhunter?
You can make a perception check.
In perception too, her arms are covered in scars all the way up, so you might be able to make a guess.
Yeah. You recognize, you get the sense that she is familiar with the blood arts, yes. Which type of blood arts, you don't know, but you get the sense that she's familiar.
What does Noh look like to V's eyes?
You see a tall... You see a tall elf with white hair, and if you have good enough eyesight, you can tell his eyes are light gray skin, as if it literally looks like there isn't any blood flowing beneath his skin.
All right, sir, whoever you are, you haven't told us your name. Sure, you have a rank. That means nothing here.
I told you my name and rank.
What was your name?
No.
See, you're well, not see, telling
this
us
is,
name.
This is what we need you to be communicative right now.
N-O-H. No.
Well, that's not how you spell it, but I'm V. I'm sure you know Gaaraa already, and this is Greer. You might know Greer and I as Aces High. We have you surrounded. There's three more of us in the buildings around you.
And then you hear Gaaraa say, Yeah, yeah. Good bluff. That'll get him in his head.
So is that what your mother said when she saw you?
What? So before anything else strange goes on, is there anybody else I need to know about before, you know, any more misunderstandings happen?
Yeah, actually, someone you might like to meet. Siren, get your butt out here.
Good morning. Hi.
We found a straggler. And, get this. He's in the military. Do you know
him? Doesn't look familiar. She's just gonna look him over, top to bottom. Siren is then going to look over at V, then look back to Grier and say, there's a reason why I don't trust him yet.
I'll step up to Noh, and I put out my hand and I say, welcome to the team. I'm sorry my existence offends you.
Well, you guys are, you're going about this fairly leisurely, correct?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. So that was the highlight of your trip over to the power source. And since you took your time with it, you do note that the moon has kind of progressed into kind of a half moon state. As you approach, you begin to see this, the kind of the purple glow. And you immediately note that its position is relatively close, or either it may even be on top of the carnival. At least what was the carnival that you remember back in proper Durval.
And Grier's stealthing on ahead to try and see the situation.
Okay. Please make a stealth roll for me. And who else was accompanying you?
Nobody.
Nobody? Just Grier. Okay, fantastic. All right. You head on up. You make your way to what you know to be the main gates of the carnival. And as you turn the block, go past the row houses where you met the boy and found Reuven's body. You turn the corner and you see the entrance to the carnival, only it is in disarray.
Do me and Noh see anything as we're up on this second story sort of building?
You can make perception checks for me. Noh, you are, so you guys, V, you get up there and, you start to look around and you're just kind of focused on the purple glow. You're just looking at it, trying to figure out what relevance it has. And then, you do see a Ferris wheel, something that you would expect to see at a carnival. It is covered in vines and looks fairly rusted. However, it's currently moving.
V, you see that Ferris wheel over there?
I do not. Where are you looking?
I'll get closer and like point it out to him.
Yep, see it now.
You see it moving?
It is. Is it supposed to be?
You wouldn't think so.
Right. All right, so let's head down. Or if you want to head down, I'll stay up here and just keep an eye on things and just let the group know that the Ferris wheel is moving.
All right, I'll be right back. I'm going to go let Lady Grier know.
I'll be right here.
So quietly, Grier's just going, I don't see anything yet, but it's definitely here. I mean, look at the glow. So you guys wait here for Noh and V, and I'm going to keep going. And every time I think we're clear, I'll try to let you know to come forward, okay? Okay. All right. And then Grier's going to press on.
Do a perception check. All right, you see Noh is coming down from his perch before you leave.
Went out the window instead of the stairs because he's cool.
Yeah. Okay. We wait for him then.
You just see V in the window and be like, there's a fucking stairs.
It's faster this way.
Okay. So Noh, you join them at the corner before the gates.
Lady Grier, I happen to spot the Ferris wheel from up there. It seems to be moving.
Where's my brother?
Oh. He's still keeping watch. I'll be heading back there shortly.
She nods, but she still gives him a really stern look.
Okay, well, the Ferris wheel should not be moving. That's bizarre.
My thoughts exactly.
All right. So, Grier, are you headed up?
Yeah, she's already going out.
Okay. So you head on up to the gate, kind of continuing your stealthy moves. I will let you keep that nat 20.
Thank you.
And you approach the gate and peek around one of the booths so you can see into the grounds. And one of the very first things you note is at the beginning, the front of the carnival is a merry-go-round. And that merry-go-round is currently moving.
God.
And you see people riding.
People? Of it.
Sorry?
You see people riding inside of it.
Let's go back. I swear to God, if there's a child's laughter.
We out!
The merry-go-round, again, is rusted, covered in vines. And you're close enough now that you can kind of hear it squeaking, and the music is twisted and kind of scratchy. It's going through old, dilapidated speakers. So you kind of creep up a little closer, trying to stay more or less in the booth area, but there's plenty to work with there. And you get a closer look at these people that are riding. And as you get closer, you do see that they are, in fact, human, elf, dwarf. But you notice something peculiar about them. All of them have some kind of growth on their back. And then from an expression standpoint, they don't appear to be, they just have a blank expression as they ride.
And they're not making any noise?
Nope. They're just sitting there riding.
Just noping straight out of that. Just nope.
I'm running up to the group from the second story floor. Guys, the light that's over there, it looks like it's coming from the amphitheater where we put on that awesome performance. Remember? And I'm just looking at Siren because the other two don't know.
Siren wasn't there.
Oh no, Siren wasn't there. Shit. Well, I say that anyway.
All right, all of you headed up.
Yep.
All right, I need a group stealth check.
Yee!
Oh my God.
12. I am not rolling above a 10 tonight, just FYI.
I can't be good at everything, I guess.
Mr. Siren, save us.
Oh no.
Oh Lord.
All right.
Well. We're just walking up there normally.
Yeah, basically that's what you do.
Gaaraa is just like mouth breathing and snickering.
Via singing.
Yeah, but you all, you all do get to Grier. But as you arrive next to Grier and you turn to look towards the Ferris wheel, as the world begins to shimmer.
Oh shit!
And all of you begin to see the carnival as it was in the
room. Oh no. Oh no.
And V,
of course,
someone jumps on your back.
I just give a silent scream.
His soul just leaves his body.
And then you hear the ever familiar voice of your friend.
Hey, V! I'm so happy to see you here!
Who the fuck is that?
It's Emily.
Oh.
Emily? No.
Hi, V!
What the fuck? Hi!
I'm so glad you guys came.
Of course. Wouldn't miss this for the world. What's going on?
Oh, my concert, silly!
Right, the concert. Yes, of course.
You've got new friends now that I haven't met before. Siren, it's a pleasure as always.
Oh, great. I'm so glad that I'm seeing you tonight, Emily.
Now, she's here to perform, and, you know, you're Ellie, and we're here to support our own.
Yep. Performs. Yep. Performing. Yep.
So, for the rest of you that have never met her before, you see a elven woman with kind of pale green skin. She's got darker green hair. It's roughly shoulder length. And she's wearing a kind of a pastel. In this case, she's got kind of a sundress on for some reason. It's kind of got a flowery layout to it. Like she's there for an easy afternoon on a nice spring day.
Everyone, this is Emily. I call her Em. Great performer. Absolutely great. She's performing tonight.
Pleasure to meet everyone.
And she just kind of runs around and like starts shaking everyone's hands.
We've met before.
Of course, Grier. I wouldn't forget you.
Would I know her, DM?
You would, just because you're creepy.
Okay.
So you would have seen her one day at Revel in Roost. She would have been performing there.
Ah, okay.
DM.
Yes.
Quick question. How aware are we that 2 seconds ago the carnival was not like this?
All of you were fully aware.
Okay.
You watched the scene change.
Okay.
Can we still hear each other's thoughts?
You can, yes. But you don't hear anything from him.
Okay. So, Agrir is just going to think to everyone, guys, this isn't real.
I know. Which is why we need to play into this, because whatever's messing with us, and I'm saying this, of course, in my head, whatever's messing with us wants us to, we just need to play along.
Byron's gonna make eyes at V, and in her thoughts, she's going to say, of all the people that we could have seen, it had to be M.
I didn't choose this scene.
She's even more annoying now.
She's probably dead here in this instance. Not, I don't know in real life, but let's just see what happens. I don't know what's going on. I don't know what's real or not. But let's just see what happens.
Really think she's dead?
I don't know.
Think she's dead?
Why else? She's dead. Why else would she be here?
That's kind of cool. Okay.
Now you're good because of the thought that she's dead.
Siren smiles and nods.
Okay.
All right. We'll follow your lead, V, but be careful. We don't know what we can't see when it's like this.
Yes, I agree 100%, which is why I want you guys near me at all times. This is why I'm asking you guys to come on stage with me. Because I don't know what's going to happen.
You got it.
So yeah, do you think there's enough room for my friends here on stage? Maybe we can get sort of like a group thing going?
Absolutely, we can figure that out. Yeah. We can get everybody on stage. It'll be great.
Hell yeah. Hell yeah. All right, let's do it.
Okay, well, I need to go prepare for the solo aspect of it, so I'm going to go do that. But when that's over, we'll, meet backstage and then plan the encore. How's that sound?
Sounds great. That sounds awesome. What day is it? What's today?
What do you mean?
With today's date. Things get really weird.
Been traveling.
Yeah.
We're a bit hungover.
Yeah, exactly. We're hungover.
That makes sense. Yeah, no. Ah, okay. And she recites the date, and it's what would be today's date.
Weird.
Oh, okay. I didn't realize we were drinking for that long. Awesome. Yeah, so yeah, come get us when you're ready. Do we need to talk to anybody or?
No, just head on in, come enjoy you could sit in the crowd, enjoy the concert, and then after that, one of my assistants will come and get you.
Oh, awesome. I didn't know you had an assistant. I think I should get one too.
Assistant?
Okay, well, it's been fun. I need to go get ready, so I'll see y'all in a bit.
Ta-ta.
Bye. Okay. And then she just starts skipping off. And as she skips off, the world returns back to its original state.
What?
And you guys are now in.
Ew.
The Carnival Fantastic.
Ew! It's gross!
What's the moon phase?
Moon phase here is still half moon.
Cool.
This is so cool.
Jesus.
And as she was skipping away, when the illusion is flipping back and forth, it is going back to the way it was, you see her, she's still there, but as the illusion goes back to the original state, you see her hair turn jet black, and her dress goes from that flowery pattern to just also a black color. Make perception checks. V, Grier, and no.
Eight plus 3, 11.
Grier. Her dress is covered in blood.
Do I see her? Like, not the details, just her in general?
Yes, everyone sees her. Skipping away, you see the dress transition, and Grier, you see the blood.
Grier immediately turns to V and starts like patting him all over and on his back. Are you bleeding?
Do I have blood on me?
Are you bleeding?
No, why?
Oh, I'm just checking, I was worried. I'm
just reaching behind my back because now she mentions it if I'm bleeding or not.
Her dress is covered in blood.
Is it fresh?
She's really dead. She's dead.
Oh my god. Oh my god. Should we keep going or should we turn around and go back home? Hands?
I high five V.
Come on. You got raw hands. Do you want to go back? He's with me. I'm just holding his hand up in the air.
We can't. It's too late.
Knows we're here, V.
That's why I met a reason to go back.
It's extended an invitation to us.
I'm going to decline that invitation. I am not obligated to go to any party that I don't want to.
V,
hey, but
it's our way home.
You also already told her that you can perform with her, so she's going to be looking for you now.
Which is more the reason why I should not show up.
What if you piss her off when she does eventually find you because you ran away?
I mean, whatever it is, I am in their territory. All right, fine. And I put Gaara's head a hand down.
You can perform for her, and if you please her, she will join our team. Yes.
No, she won't, Gaara. No.
Absolutely not, Gaara.
Don't know if we want. Actually.
No.
No, V.
Okay.
You guys continue on. The rest of the trip is
mostly uneventful as you try to quietly move across, but not too quietly. You arrive at the amphitheater, and in front of the amphitheater, you see two individuals standing at the gates. The gates are currently closed.
I'm just gonna, at the sight of this, I'm gonna throw my hands up. Guys, I can't do this, and I'm gonna try and turn around and go the other way.
I'm gonna keep walking, just grab him, turn him back around, and keep walking forward.
God, I don't know if I can do this.
I got your back, you're chilling. You'll be fine.
I got his back, no, you're fine.
We're just not gonna let dirty look. Anything happen.
Yes, Lieutenant.
V. Grier, Siren. You recognize both of them, actually. First one is a drow gentleman that you recognize as the man that your dwarven friend V punched in the face at the bar.
Oh!
When he was very angry about him hitting on his sister. During the bar fight.
Oh my god.
The other one is a dragonborn fellow, which V, you would recognize as Brutic from the Apothesis Lab.
Greer is in front of me.
Yep.
Just gonna, all right, tell them that we're performing and we need to get in there. Play it up.
Oh yeah, because I'm good at that.
You'll do just fine. I believe in you. And then I just tap her on the shoulder and give her bardic inspiration. So you all have right. a D8 for whatever you're about to do.
All right.
Hey.
Greer just takes a deep breath and steps forward towards them. We were invited to the performance.
Brutic turns to you. And he goes, well, that's nice, but you still need to pay for a ticket. I don't got you on a list.
Greer, you hear in your head V's voice, do you know who I am? I'm trying to tell you to say that.
Greer's going to confuse it.
Oh, fuck. Yep.
And gesture at V going, do you know who he is?
Yeah. It's that asshole that got my friend's head cut off. You're the one that did it.
Oops.
Now, where I am performing, at the request of the lady. So I don't think we need tickets, sir.
Like I said, you ain't on a list. I've got one performer for tonight. It's Emily. There is not a you here.
We made arrangements with Emily, actually, that we would be on stage with her to perform.
During her act?
Yes. She has a solo act and she has an act with us. So if you would kindly... I'm sorry about your friend, by the way. Didn't mean to get his head cut off. But bygones be bygones. It's neither here nor there. If you could so kindly let us through so we can do our performance and be out of your hair.
And if you would kindly buy a ticket, I'll let that happen.
How much?
It's only 10 gold per person.
5 gold it is. And I put my hand out to shake. Do I have money?
He just looks at you.
Siren does.
Everybody, you can make perception checks.
There we go. 30, 20.
Why am I rolling that once?
Oh, Lord.
Literally. Oh, Siren's so failing today.
As you're walking up to him, he just kind of slightly turns. He just slaps your hand away because he doesn't... You're clearly speaking down to him. But you see a growth on his back.
Oh, fine. 10 gold. Just one? For all
per
of
person?
Us?
God damn per it. Person.
Is, look. Let's make a deal here.
Does the deal involve my friend coming back?
We can figure that out. We are in Vassia, after all.
Her head was cut off, V. Greer
just thinks that to you.
She can't come back.
And I say in my head, he doesn't know that.
Yes, he does.
No, he doesn't know that she can't.
You hear in Gaaraa's head, well, if you have the head, she can come back.
There you go. We have...
It was separated.
We have a necromancer.
And we don't have the body.
They don't know that. We need to get in there, and I'm willing to say anything to get in there without paying.
And then you hear in your head, well, you can keep trying.
The fuck? What was that? And I look around. I walk away to the group.
Siren's gonna stand, like, she's gonna take a step toward Bartek, almost like Rudy, shouldering yeah. V out of the way.
Okay.
And she's gonna say, if we pay you the 50 gold, will you move?
That buys a ticket, and it's 60 gold.
Okay, there's your 60 gold, now move.
Puts the gold in a box in the ticket booth, pulls out a couple of pieces of paper, and then walks back out with them, and then hands you six blank pieces of paper.
Excellent.
We got swindled by ghosts, guys.
Just get the money later. Exactly. We can come back later.
Every seat has someone in it, and you see them just cheering. There's like guys holding, there's people holding signs up that, you know, professing their love to Emily. There are other people waving the like stick lights, like cheering on Emily. You can see her on stage right now. The concert has already begun. And she is singing just her heart out. And just like before at the original show, she's kind of singing in an upbeat tone, but she's moving back and forth between Elvish and Common and dancing around the stage very brightly. And then as you look across the crowd, it begins to dawn on you. As you look at these people that are cheering, you look at their joints, and they're bald. You see the ball joints.
Ew.
And then you kind of look above their, like coming down from there, you see what appears to be faint strings controlling their joints as they are cheering her on.
If I may, Benedict knows all of your moves, V. Perhaps you can do some choreography together.
Yeah. That sounds good. And I'm just grinning with my, like, clenching my teeth at the at the thought of dancing with Benedict.
Yes. Excellent. Excellent.
Sure. Let's do that. And then I guess Gaaraa sing that song that you sing alone, except now you sing it to a crowd of puppets.
Well,
and if you need me to be present, I can probably throw swords in the air and catch them. I don't know.
Perfect.
If there's blood, there's a bonus.
If you sort of fuck up, it works. And then you can do something with it. I don't know exactly what you do.
Oh, God. All right.
Are we good with this plan? Me and Benedict here, we will dance to Gaaraa's lonely song. And if need be, actually, no, you're going to do it because now I'm dancing with a zombie. So now you have to just throw swords. We're in this together.
Oh, okay, I guess.
Delightful.
Okay. Who do we talk to about this?
I don't think we talk to anybody. I think we should just go.
Okay, so after she's done performing, we just go up on stage.
Okay. You see a figure come out from behind the curtain and begin to rush towards you guys. V and Greer, actually, I think Siren as well, because you were there the second time. You immediately recognize this as the man that you helped deal with his wife's missing body in the Ryland case.
Oh.
All right. Miss Emily said I need to coordinate with you guys about what you're going to do, so that we can do the encore performance.
Yeah. Good to see you. How you doing? How's everything? You doing all right?
You know, I'm doing okay. You know, it's still rough, but you know, I've got purpose now.
Good.
You know, helping out Miss Emily.
Great. Are you her assistant? Are you the one that she's talking about?
Yeah. I'm kind of her stage manager.
So awesome. Well, hey. Good that you're back on your feet. Okay, Siren and Noh, now that he's gone, go find a spot to hide.
Emily comes into the green room. And she pops in, she's like, that performance went great!
It was really good.
You can hear
good.
Them out there?
Yeah, 100%. Yeah, I mean, of course, your performances are always great.
I know they are. Everybody loves me.
Yep. It's almost like someone's pulling strings out there. It's crazy.
It's weird, isn't it?
Yeah, it's insane.
Yeah.
So what's are we up next?
Yeah, we're ready to go out there. We can just immediately do I've got an idea for the encore that I think you'll love. It'll be great.
Oh, we sort of had an idea too.
Oh,
yeah.
What you got?
Well, you know me. I'm gonna dance with my buddy here, and I'm gonna motion over to Benedict. And Gaaraa over here is going to sing us a lovely tune that he sings by himself.
Gaaraa is just like blushing, beet red.
And Grier is going to juggle some swords.
And she turns to Gaaraa and you want to be lead singer, huh? And as she says that, you see the briefest glimpse of Emily go from the green form into the black form, jet black hair, blood red eyes. And then it goes back to the green form.
Oh, well, I don't mean to intrude if you want to take the lead.
Gaaraa, do you wanna just run her through real fast on the song? And she's a quick learner, she'll get it.
I'll try my best, and then I'll just whisper very discreetly into her ear how the song goes.
God. She snaps her head to you. Oh, you're telling me what song to sing.
Oh, forgive me. It's the only song I know.
I think it'll be great. I think it'll be great. You know, it'll broaden your sort of scope of talent, you know?
Will it?
Yeah. I think so.
I feel like as the star, I know what my strengths are, but you don't think I'm good, V?
Look, I don't want to steal any of the thunder, which is why I'm totally okay with being a backup dancer.
I mean, we all do know that V is the best performer here.
Well, second best.
Is he now?
Second best. She's second best.
He is, actually.
He's never beat me.
Yep, you are.
In any competition ever.
100% correct, which is why I'm willing to take a backup dancer's position, as much as that pains me to say.
But you know what's interesting about that? He's never beaten you, but his music has 100 times more heart in it than yours ever will.
Yeah. Oh, you misunderstand the entertainment industry. Talent and heart doesn't matter, only the number of fans.
If I remember, V, you do this not because of fans. You do it because you love music and you love people. You don't care if you're known. You just want your music to spread.
That is true. That is true, which is why I enjoy performing in front of a smaller audience. But that's neither here nor there. We're here for, and I try and boop her on the nose, for M. This is her show, and we are the backup.
Well, then I guess you're just going to follow my lead.
And I just nudge Gaaraa. Yep.
Yes, I will.
Okay. Don't disappoint me.
Oh my God.
Don't disappoint her.
I'm getting anxious.
Gaaraa, believe in yourself. We all here believe in you. You got this, Gaaraa.
I will try my best.
There's a mosh pit forming in front of the stage, and as Emily walks forward, you see her normal tones change. She goes to the jet black hair, and you see her attire. She goes into like a black tank top and leathery pants. She's got metallic studded belt. And she has an entire sleeve on her right arm, and it's just all inked up. And as you're looking at this ink, the sleeve, you just see it appears to depict her as a marionette over V.
Love the look. You got a Hot Topic before coming here, or?
It just seemed more appropriate for this type of music.
I think it's awesome.
She turns and just lets out a growl. And that is the signal the performance begins. So we will start with Gaaraa.
Oh my gosh.
Here we go. Don't let us down.
You have seen what has happened before you. She has completely disregarded everything that you asked for, and she has gone full metal in front of you. What does Gaaraa do?
So I try to listen in on her singing pattern, and I try to kind of growl, like in between, like her growling as kind of like a backup vocals, like in a rock song.
Okay. All right. So I want you to make a performance check for me. Oof.
Whatever this is.
Come on, Gaaraa.
Three.
It's beautiful.
It's metal. All right. It doesn't matter.
It's literally just.
Yeah. And as that is happening, a spotlight pops out and just lands on top of Emily. Greer.
We're tossing some swords in the air and we're trying to catch them, man.
Okay.
Metal as fuck.
Give me a performance check.
Is this a disadvantage?
No, because it's metal as fuck.
Hell yeah. No matter what you do, it's going to be metal as fuck.
All right. Ooh. You begin tossing these swords around and dancing with them. It's fairly fluid. And the crowd in the mosh pit takes notice and just immediately starts cheering for the fact that you're fucking throwing swords around while this is happening. Emily kind of takes notice of what you're doing, gives you a bit of a nod, but then just immediately turns to the ground and amps up her own performance. And then another spotlight pops onto Emily.
I'm looking around. I start to dance, but I'm looking around now and it's not going as planned. So I'm going to play into it as I do. And I'm going to whip out my lute and attempt a solo fucking shredder.
All
that
right.
Goes along with the song.
Okay. Do a performance check for me.
Don't choke. 23.
Come on, V. Hey.
Okay. Nice.
Attaboy, V.
You sense the spot in the song where now's the time for the solo, and you just absolutely rip it. Emily walks up and just starts like headbanging next to you as you're doing it. The crowd just goes absolutely bonkers. And then the spotlight shines on you.
Okay.
And Emily stops headbanging.
I just look at Emily as I'm still shredding, just like side-eyeing her.
And she just kind of gives you a smile and then returns back to center stage. A very unsettling smile. You see the brief, you know, her eyes, you just look at them and you see disdain in what's happening.
So, and I see that Siren is readying her grenade launcher?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. So at the sight of this, I am going to cast pyrotechnics as part of this performance.
Okay.
And I'm going to do, I'm going to make sort of, to add to the production and atmosphere, I'm going to add thick black smoke that spreads from myself in a 20-foot radius.
Okay. So you set this off and the smoke begins to just bursts around you. And the entire group, all four of you, are engulfed in this smoke because you're all within 20 feet of one another.
Okay. Siren is going to kind of very softly wave her hand in Noh's direction to let him know, like, either hold on or move because I'm about to shoot. And she's going to hold up the grenade launcher.
I'm going to brace myself. Ready an arrow.
Oh, God.
Oh, yeah. And she is going to attempt to shoot a corrosive grenade.
Okay.
Here we go.
I want you to just do, just do an attack roll.
Oh, my God. Okay.
In big concern right now.
How do I do that with the grenade
launcher? Just do a, just do it in any attack roll.
Okay. Mother flip-flop.
You see it burst and you see the acid splash against the side of the device. You see it begin to bubble and start to melt, but then it stops and it reforms. And as that's happening, you hear a screech from the mic dropping as Emily grabs her head. I need all of you to roll initiative.
Oh, shit. Oh. Here we go.
Okay.
Oh, no. Nat 1.
Yeah, I have a disadvantage on initiative, right?
Okay. Gaaraa, you're up.
Okay. Gaaraa's never been in a fight before, so he's scared out of his mind. He runs, he takes a step back. Benedict, just like we practiced, it's happening for real. And he commands him to charge at Emily. I'm going to use my third level Ray of Sickness.
Okay.
So
fire away. You said it's a third level?
Yeah. So that's 13.
Okay. You fire off the Ray of Sickness and it hits her, but she just kind of bats it away. Like, she just kind of moves, sidesteps it a bit, so it doesn't, you just miss her.
Oh, okay. And I'm scared, so I just move behind Benedict as a meat shield.
Emily will attack V.
Bring it, bitch.
She's always been jealous of him.
Yeah, so first attack.
I have 19.
25.
So, can I silvery barbs her?
Ooh, shit.
You can, sure. Yep.
Watch out.
All right, so she will do it again. What level? 24. 24
still hits.
Yep. So you take 11 points of piercing damage.
Ouch!
Yeah, so you were hit by her blade. And as the original blade was piercing you, you felt something odd. I need you to make a wisdom saving throw.
Oh, fuck.
Can I give you the...
Come on, wise guy.
A 14. Am I gonna need disadvantage? What?
Did you give?
You will need the advantage.
Okay, so I will roll again. Thank you, Gaaraa.
for my friend V.
14 okay. still.
Oh. Okay, I need you to roll a d6 for me.
Oh, no. Oh, God.
A 2.
Okay. You feel the blade pierce you and then pull back. And as it's leaving, you see Emily back in her normal form. And you realize something. Why are you fighting her? You should be protecting her. You're her white knight.
Oh, no.
Oh, God.
I need you to use your reaction to immediately attack the nearest non-Emily next to you. So it'd be Benedict.
It'd be Benedict.
Hey, God. Oh, my friends. Don't fight each other.
Just do a melee attack against him.
You got it. That's fine. That's a 9.
Okay. So in your weird stupor, you turn around and you're like kind of shocked by Benedict being there. And you kind of do a quick swipe and miss him. But then as that's happening, Emily will use her bonus action to disengage into the smoke.
I don't know if this will do much, but she's going to shoot a shock grenade.
Okay.
Or attempt anyway. So she will attempt. Oh my God. Okay. Please. Please.
Okay. So again, you fire towards it and it bounces in the same way. And once again, the explosion lands on the edge of the radius.
Come on, Siren. Mother flip.
Okay. Whopping one. Here we go. Emily will perform a legendary action.
Oh, boy.
This bitch ain't legendary. Oh, I'm sorry.
But say, I haven't seen this shit in a while.
Emily appears next to you in the rafters.
Oh!
Scare me.
Oh, no.
Gaaraa shrieks in terror.
I just left him up there.
And she will attack you. And that is going to miss, unless you have really low AC, which I doubt.
I have 16.
Yeah, you're fine. So that was an 11. And she just takes a swing at you with her dagger. And that's the end. So there's Emily next to you.
I don't even like your performances.
Oh, fuck. She went up there and fucked all my ideas. Greer's gonna move out of the smoke, and she's up. They're like 20 feet in the air, right?
Yeah.
And she is going to fire her flying daggers at him.
Okay.
Fire it.
Yes.
All right.
Seeing that Greer is attacking his.
And again.
He is going to Silvery Barbs Greer.
All right, Greer, you need to reroll.
And I will give advantage to M.
Oh, you whore. Oh, that's the wrong button, sorry.
Oh, God.
And by the way, the White Knight effect only lasts until the start of your next turn.
Yep.
It's a 15. Is 15 hit?
It misses.
Oh!
Greer, as you do that, you're like, what the fuck just happened? And you look over at me, and I'm just standing. I have my rapier in my hand, and I'm just looking at you. You can see I have my hand out. You can see like silver tendrils moving towards you. And I don't look myself. I just smile. I tilt my head and I smile.
Oh God, it's fucking creepy. So the silver guards.
I'd like to do the blood curse of binding on her. For my bonus action.
Okay.
She needs to succeed. Yep. Okay. She needs to succeed on DC 13 strength throw.
Oh.
Nat 20.
Damn. All right. Well then. I'll shoot her in the. I'll just shoot her once.
Now you are firing a bow at point blank, so I will need that at disadvantage. Which, yeah. So yeah, disadvantage.
Oh, okay. God.
The surprise of her appearing before you and you just chaotically trying to address her. you just fire wide, and she's ducking and dodging, and she's just very difficult to hit, and you miss.
All right, I'd like to scurry down the scaffolding.
Okay. She's going to use her reaction to try and hit you.
Opportunity attack, buddy.
Yep.
Okay. So that is a 15, which I believe is not good. Yep, she misses. You can scurry on down.
And lucky just, son of a bitch.
Yeah. And then walk 10 feet away.
Yes, and walk 10 feet away.
Siren, help.
Siren, help me.
Help.
Okay. So, V, you're up. You're kind of snapping back. You just realize what you did to Benedict and Grier as you come back to your normal self.
Oh, shit. Oh. Sorry. Sorry. And then I'm going to...
Do you want to get rid of your smoke screen?
I can't get rid of it.
Oh, you can't?
No, it's just there until
round five.
Round five, or a gust of smoke blows it away.
Yeah, gust of wind. Emily will use a legendary action.
Oh my god.
Beautiful.
She will turn to you and cast a spell. I need you to make a wisdom saving throw on Gaaraa.
Good luck, buddy.
Oh my god.
Okay. On your turn, I need you to roll a d10 for me. All right. You see this as she turns and casts the spell on you. And you just kind of, as it's happening, your mind just goes completely blank. And you can do nothing on this turn. Oh. As you are suffering from confusion.
Oh dear.
Oh my god.
He's making that exact face as his picture.
Yeah.
Yeah. Emily appears out of the smoke behind you. Oh my god.
There's two?
And she will attack you.
Bring it.
Nat 1. 18.
Yikes. Can I parry it?
You can try, sure. You gotta beat an 18 on your attack roll.
Let's go!
Let's do it.
Alright.
She learned from B.
Alright, so you parry it, and she just kind of scoffs at you, and then uses her bonus action to disengage back into the... somewhere in the smoke. And she's going to take a legendary action and attack Noh.
Oh no!
God damn
really
it, Emily!
Sorry.
Come on!
I'm sorry, Noh.
You left him. Noh.
Twice.
25.
Every time you have cannon fodder.
Silvery barbs. That one.
Okay.
Oh, I'm running out of spell slots, guys.
Okay, careful. 10 for the follow-up.
Misses.
Yeah, so it does miss after the silvery barbs. Now I need you to roll a d10 for me.
Ooh. So that's 8 damage. All right. Mm-hmm. D10.
Odds, you hit the real enemy. Evens, you hit the fake one.
Ah! Oh.
All right. Real enemy it is.
Yeah!
Grier on the other side of her. On the other side of you, Grier. All of a sudden, you're gonna hear a weird, like a bunch of smacking, like wood hitting itself, and kind of, maybe bones forming behind you. And next to you is going to, you're going to see V! V's on your right, but there's another V on your left.
Hello.
Um,
double the fun.
Siren is gonna look horrified.
Yeah, Grier's just looking back and forth going, ah, oh, fuck.
V, what is your AC?
15.
What's your HP?
38 max. Okay.
I need you to make an attack roll against Grier.
Wow. Grier is going to kill V.
15. It's not me. She knows it's not me.
Okay. I know it's not him.
So that
she's
just hits.
She's not mad at him.
That hits.
That just hits.
Oh, God.
Grier, you take 11 damage.
Yep.
It will blade flourish.
Oh, my God.
So that's just a D8.
Yeah, it's going to do... so roll your D8. And it's going to do a slashing flourish.
6.
So you take an additional 6 damage.
That's all.
This V is better than me.
As you look at this thing, this V next to you, you see ball joints and strings from the top of him.
What the fuck, puppet V?
Yeah, it's a little weird.
It hurts more than you do.
What?
Then I'm gonna fire at that V, the puppet one.
Okay. Fire away.
Hey, yo!
It hits. Do your damage.
Damn.
6.
Okay.
And I can't do my Crimson Rite because bonus action was Misty Step, so I'll just attack again.
Can you see his HP?
No.
Oh my God.
Okay.
Ooh. There you go.
All right. So you just wail. You just quick fire 2 shots at him after swiftly teleporting over, and you just see both of them just land center chest and pierce right through. You see like little bits of wood kind of come shattering out from his back as the arrows pierce through. That's everything for you?
Yeah, that's it.
All right, V, you're up.
Part of me was to fight myself.
take the portal.
I'm gonna swing at the device.
Okay.
21.
Okay, that hits.
7. 12 damage.
Alright, roll a d10 for me.
I believe it has an AC of 17, right?
If you were paying attention.
I hit the fake one.
You hit the fake one.
Fuck.
And reappear next to you guys.
Elderel shit.
And she will attack Siren.
Come at me, bitch.
17. It hits.
Silvery barbs. I'm supposed to...
okay. Oh, wait, that's the wrong one. 25 on that
one. Oh, God, I'm sorry.
It's okay.
I made it worse.
So you see the blade come out, and you feel it pierce your skin. You take 9 points of piercing damage.
Damn!
So you take 9 points of piercing damage, and then she twists the blade.
Oh.
And you feel your mind get racked.
Oh, God.
As you take an additional 9 points of psychic damage. Everyone except for Grier and Gaaraa, you feel this this burst of energy come out. And your mind just gets snapped. And it just erupts into pain. All of you take 17 points of damage.
What?
The two of you that saved take half that amount. For the next minute, anytime you roll for an attack or an ability check, you do a d6 and subtract it.
Uh-oh.
You, question why you're fighting her.
No.
And you are her white knight. Oh, no. And I need you to attack the nearest person to you that is hostile to Emily, which is V.
I'm not hostile to Emily.
Oh my god.
Technically, I'm not hostile to Emily.
Oh, actually, no. Yeah, you know, actually, you're right. Based off the rules I wrote, you have to attack either Noh or Siren.
Which means I have to move away from this other V.
You have to move away from the other V.
All right, it's going for Siren.
All right, go ahead. So you move away. The other V lets you go.
Okay.
Make an attack against Siren.
Greer, can you move like over here instead of back there?
It misses, I'm guessing.
Right, it misses. Oh.
Thank God.
Thank you, Greer. She's gonna try and do the same thing.
Okay.
Maybe. Come on.
Come on, Siren.
Oh, okay.
Natural play.
Roll damage and roll a d10 for me.
Okay. Yeah.
Fuck her up, Siren.
Oh, all those dice. I heard it. Oh my god.
Nice. Roll a d10 for me.
Come on, Siren.
Unfortunate. As you strike down onto it, you feel the weight behind the blow. You are pleased with your attack. But something else happens this time.
Oh, no.
As the Emily that's standing next to you guys bursts into colorful lights. I need everyone with a 10-foot radius to make a dexterity saving throw.
God,
mother.
So everyone besides Gaaraa.
When can I do my natural bonus 20. Action?
Okay, you're fine, V.
24.
I rolled a 10. No, never mind. It's a 16.
Oh, okay. Siren.
Siren. Unfortunate. As you happen to catch the lights and you are blinded.
Blinded by the light. Music's making me go crazy.
That's the whole point. I need you to make a wisdom saving throw.
Excellent. So that is 16.
All right. V, what's your save?
My spell save?
Mm-hmm.
17.
Yeah.
Motherfucker.
Sorry, I'm so good.
As you walk up, the weird puppet V leans up to you and just starts whispering sweet nothings into your ear.
Oh.
You take 15 points of psychic damage.
Uh-huh.
And you need to run for your life.
And we're going 20 into the smoke.
Oh. Okay.
Wait, what did he say?
So V, what would you have said in her ear?
What would real V have said in a moment like this?
What would real V have done? Yes. What kind of creepy way could you seduce her?
Oh.
Hang on, let me grab some popcorn.
I like the way you smell.
Oh my god.
That sounds like a Gaaraa line.
It does.
A V would say that, but not in that way. This V, creepy V would say it in that way.
Okay.
Gone instantly.
All right, so that was his turn.
I want to wear your face.
You go and get a lotion on its skin.
I like your skin.
It rubs the lotion on its skin.
Is it still alive?
It is still alive, but it is fucked up.
Okay, well, I'll give V a quick nod and then I'll shoot again.
Okay. Fire away.
Oof.
You fire through the hole in its chest.
Nice. You're so good.
I have such good grouping. It's okay.
You're auto-putting it.
You take 8 points of piercing damage. He twists the blade. He smiles at you as she knows what it, and she knows what's about to happen. You take 8 points of psychic damage. Then she starts laughing.
Oh, God.
As you collapse to the ground. She pulls the blade back and the blood splashes across her and she seems to welcome it.
Siren's attacking this bitch.
Okay.
Careful of the AoE.
Nice.
When she dies.
All right.
There you go. Come on, you can do it.
That's my baby.
So satisfying to hear.
It's so good.
Come on.
Odds. Odds.
One odds.
Okay, D10.
D10. Odds are even.
I'm gonna throw up. I can't look. Don't tell me. I can't look.
Yeah! You land your attack clean, and you still have one more.
Oh, she's going for it.
Go for it.
Oh, that hits. And a D10, which Emily absorbs.
Go on, Siren.
Oh my God. This is for Greer.
Go on, Siren.
Here we go.
Crazy.
I do want to action surge.
All right.
And then you swing
surge.
Two more times.
And then you swing again.
Swing away home.
Aww. Maybe?
That hits.
Oh,
D10.
Come on, baby.
All right.
And this is why you're so high ranked in the Marines.
Yep. And this is why she's terrifying, even though you don't realize it at first.
Okay. And swing again.
Oh my God, I'm literally sweating right now.
Come up, Siren.
All right.
Oh my God.
One more turn. One more. Let's see. And a D10.
Oh my God, guys, please.
Oh.
Okay, it was a good run.
All right.
Yeah, sure. So I get to feel for, I'm gonna go right there.
Okay, I will let
She gets a swing, yeah?
Yep, she gets a swing. 25.
25?
Okay. Yeah.
Holy shit.
So I can't use extra bonus action.
It doesn't matter because as you go to run away, you feel the blade, like a second blade, come in just square in your back. You take 11 points of piercing damage and 9 points of psychic damage. As everyone can see, Emily smiling, laughing, giggling to herself. As yet another person goes to the ground and you fall right next to where you were. V, you're up.
Now I'm gonna bonus action mass healing word.
All right, there we go.
What's the range on this? 60 feet. So I think I can get everybody. I'm gonna pull my lute out and do some, you know, country strumming. And you're gonna, anyone that's not blind, you can see the sort of a silvery flame appear on the strings as it emanates out and soothes your pain for a moment.
I literally get stabbed in the back, face plant, and then stand right back up.
So use your action.
I still have my action.
Yes.
After strumming my lute of the soothing sounds, I'm going to use my action and I'm going to hit a fucking power chord and cast thunderous chord.
Okay.
So everyone that can hear this within 100 feet make a constitution saving throw, DC 17.
Alright. And what's the damage?
2d6. 8.
Okay.
So it's if you it's pass you get nothing.
It looks like everyone's taking 8 thunder damage. Literally everyone took 8 thunder damage.
Except for Siren. She's used to my music.
Yeah.
Siren's grown up with it.
So, okay.
That was the first attack?
That was the first attack. Mm-hmm. And then the second attack comes in. 16.
Hits. Do it.
And again, she's just reveling in the fact this keeps happening. As you take an additional 10 points of damage, piercing damage, and 8 points of psychic damage, and you go back down.
Yep.
I think we're dead in the water here, guys.
No, we're not. We can do this.
After that, now that you guys are not blinded anymore, she does look fairly fucked up.
Fairly fucked up. Okay.
Yeah.
Now, after coming out of blindness, V is just gonna snap out of it and look around. He's gonna see Grier down, and he's just gonna run towards her.
Okay.
And I'll take the opportunity attack.
Okay.
And I'm going to pour a potion of superior healing. So 18 plus 8. You heal for that.
Yeah.
Okay.
26.
You okay?
Hi?
Hi. How do we stop this thing?
We kill it.
We're working on it.
And we stop bleeding ourselves.
I think that's a good idea. And that is my turn.
Okay. That's great.
So you're getting your great sword back into normal position. Roll again. And that hits. Roll damage. Yeah. For me. Okay.
Please.
How do you want to do this?
Yes!
What? No! Oh, no!
Oh, thank God.
No way! No! Get it, Siren.
Okay, Siren is so fucking excited right now. She fucking fist pumps the air. She takes her sword. She like swings it in the air like fucking baton, and then slices her head clean off.
Okay.
Feels good, don't it?
Oh, yeah.
And as you see her head, you slice her head off. And it kind of, the head goes flying, but then it kind of fades away. And you see a small crystal form where her like heart would have been, and then it falls to the ground. And next to that crystal that's on the ground, it's in a pool of blood, and there is a small wooden puppet inside the pool of blood.
I'm gonna make sure Grier's doing okay. You okay?
Yeah. That fight sucked.
That wasn't at all how I thought this was gonna go.
Is this how your guys' fights usually go?
More or less. Welcome, badly, yes. Welcome to the club.
The bangle. Well, I'm assuming you're holding the bangle and the crystal. So you have those other two as well.
Wait, who does? Gaaraa has both.
Well, Gaaraa just has the puppet at the moment, and you have the crystal and the bangle.
Okay, Siren's gonna put the bangle on.
Don't even investigate it. Just put it on.
Putting it on, like hell yeah, bitch.
Okay.
So this puppet's gonna look like a mini Gaaraa.
If you want it to look like a mini Gaaraa, it looks like a mini Emily right now.
Yeah.
Why would you want that?
Gaaraa is gonna hold it up like a baby.
Oh,
my new friend. Benedict, look, a new friend.
It's a little you. Oh, that's cute.
Oh,
I hate that. It's just that weirder.
Yeah.
Hate that a lot.
Baby Gaaraa.
Well, you hold on to that, and do what you will.
Congratulations on your new baby. But we still have to figure out this thing in front of us.
How to destroy this fucking thing.
And you said it was like a liquid in there?
It looks like a watery portal, but when you touch it, like now that you're touching it, there's no actual liquid. It's just kind of an effect that is happening. It appears to be just magical energy condensed inside of this ring. Grier, you hold the crystal in your hands. The weight feels familiar. You've seen these gems before. You've seen this crystal before. In your dream. You used one of these in Nova Lavina.
So Grier just drops it and backs away.
What's happening? What happened? You okay?
Do you recognize it?
No.
Do you remember the last dream we all had that we never talked about?
There were many dreams to refresh my memory.
One where I made the exclusion zone.
Oh.
With one of these.
Right. So, I mean, this obviously has something to do. I mean, do you remember how you made the exclusion zone with this?
It's fuzzy. There was a blue gem, and I took it out and put one like this in instead. And that did something bad.
I think this might be our answer to this thing. I mean, if you don't want to do it, I'll do it.
Break it. I don't want to touch it.
I put it back down on the ground. Whoever wants to do it.
We can have the zombie do it.
Oh yeah.
We could do that.
Let's all stand back as he does it though.
Are you up for this?
Yeah, mate, sounds fun.
Alright, you got it, champ.
Benedict takes it, and then he just kind of looks at everybody, and then he just throws it on the ground as hard as he can, and the crystal shatters. And when it does, from the ring, there is a massive burst of energy. A column of light stretches into the sky, and when you look up, what is just the normal black inky void lights up, and that section of the sky appears as it does around the moon as it passes. You see what appear to be thousands and thousands of painted glass all on just layered on top of one another with visages of other worlds. And then the pillar of light ceases and the device shuts down.
Well done, Benedict.
Thanks, mate.
Good job. You're one step closer to being an ace.
Hey! You hear that, guy?
I'm so proud of you.
And I hate to break up the celebration, but I will point out we just shot a giant beam of light into the sky in a place where it's always night.
And we are surrounded by those things outside.
We're surrounded by other things that we don't even know about. Suggest we leave quickly.
You find Brutik and the other gentleman dead on the ground.
Oh, I can get my money back.
Do they still have the spores on their backs?
Whatever that
fleshy
growth was is gone.
Anything interesting? What does your necromantic mind see?
I a potential friend.
Oh, okay.
No, no.
We don't want to raise all of them. I think Benedict is a handful enough.
We gave you a pass with Benedict. If you do it again, you're going to make us angry.
I've made plenty of friends. And I, like, hold up the puppet.
Yep, that's not going to get any easier to look at. All right, let's... if there's nothing else we want to do here, I say, how's the moon look? Okay, the moon is setting. We need to go back.
As you guys are exiting, you pass through the main gates. As the carnival is now quiet, nothing moves within it. And that is where we will end tonight.
Fuck.
Oof. Hate to say a V, but fuck carnivals.
I agree. I'm never going to look at carnivals the same.
Never again.
As the tapestry of this adventure unfolds, you can change the weaves of fate by liking and sharing these tales. Keep a watchful eye by subscribing and leave a comment that could shape the future of this world. Farewell for now, Observer. Until next time.